So, as I said, all of us, you know, Dharma, the Dharma, what is the purpose of everything the Dharma, you know? That is very important to understand. If you don't understand this, then people make mistakes. Then they, some people think it's a trend, and that's what they mean, practice the Dharma. Yeah, well, I won't call it a practice, you know. I won't get into the Dharma thinking it's a trend, you know. Or some people want to, you know, Dharma, something a little different. And it looks a little different, but for example, the Buddha Dharma, you know, which doesn't have the eight precepts, so they think it's a little different. So they get into this to attract people. You know, because in a hundred, if you are the only one who does something different from the others, then it looks a little attractive to others. You know, so for that purpose, you carry a beetle, you know, a mala. Carry a textbook and then you know, wear different clothes and then sit there and act like you're doing something. You know, but inside, that is not true Dharma. You know, that is mixed with full of ego, full of you know, jealousy, full of ignorance. So that is not what should be. You know, so as I said, all beings don't want suffering as you yourself. So Dharma should be able to remove the suffering from all beings. It should be able to remove the suffering that you are suffering, and then liberate you from the suffering, you know, permanently. You know, so this is what Dharma should be, you know, should do. And that is why one should practice the Dharma. So with the goal or aim to benefit all beings to be free from this suffering, you know, the samsara. And the suffering of samsara can be liberated from this. And ultimately, I think the realization of ultimate realization, which is enlightenment. And for that purpose, any practice diligently. You know? So this is the proper way of practicing the Dharma. And so that should be your goal as a practitioner. So keeping that in mind, then, for example, now we say Buddhist followers. So, as a Buddhist, we take refuge in the Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha. You know? So, now, it is important to understand the quality of the Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha. So, through understanding the quality of the three jewels, then you develop this unconditional faith in them. You know? So, through this unconditional faith, then you take refuge. And then, that's the proper way of taking a refuge. Otherwise, without understanding the quality, then taking refuge, you know, due to good karma, you know, past life, good karma, you have positive merit. So due to these, you come in contact with the Dharma and take refuge. But if you don't understand the quality of the three jewels, what is Dharma, if you don't understand this, then it is not stable. You know, your faith is not stable. If someone comes tomorrow and gives you a wrong view, you know, there's something else, then you are not sure. You know, and then there's a danger of you, you know, having a wrong view and losing your faith. So, very important to understand the quality. Buddha himself said, you know, you should not follow me blindly. You know, you should check what I'm saying, whether it's correct or not, whether it's true or not, whether it's beneficial or not. You know, like how a goldsmith tests the gold, you know, he rubs it, you know, and then polishes. Burns it, rub all that, and see whether the gold is pure or not. You know, so in the same way, you know, you check my, you know, the Dharma that I teach. And then, if it is really meaningful, if it is really beneficial, if it really makes sense, then follow it. So that is how we should do it. So, understand. For that purpose, then it is very important to understand the Dharma. You know, not just blind faith, but understanding it. So that is why, you know, a center like this, you know, it is very, very important. It is very good. You know, because here we teach the Dharma, you know, teaching, the philosophy. We, so all this is taught here. So it is very good. You know, it is very important, all this. So, understanding of the Dharma is very important. Then, okay. Thank you so much. Sorry. Is this 可能上级说这四个点，当中就是胜利，现在胜利是吧？当中就是当中战胜的，然后作为一个责任是吧？我得到答案就是你嘛，对，付出今天的努力，过得去，是吧？
刚刚人们介说到佛法，什么是佛法，什么是修行的目的，那这是非常，这是我们要先了解这一点，这是非常重要的。如果说我们不知道什么是佛法，什么是修行的目的，那么在修行的过程中我们就会犯错。因为有一些人他修佛法是因为他觉得佛法是一个法门，与众不同的，让自己可以就是跟别人是好像高人一等或者与众不同的东西，然后是一种可以吸引别人的而来修佛法，比如说戴着念珠啦，然后抱着佛经到处走啦，觉得自己就是高人一等这样子。但是其实这样子来修佛法的时候，心中是充满了我执跟无知的。那就刚刚讲到说，所有的众生都不想要痛苦，那么佛法是什么？佛法就是可以让痛苦解脱的一种方法，能够让你永恒的、很久的从痛苦中解脱，这是佛法的真正的作用。这就是为什么我们要去修行的一个原因，也就是说，我们可以从轮回中永恒的解脱，然后我们可以得到究竟的了悟。我们要为这样子的目的来修行佛法，这才是真正的一个真正的目的跟原因，然后这样子才是一个真正的行者，它就是我们要谨记在心的。那我们说我们就是佛教徒，我们皈依了三宝佛法僧。什么是三宝佛法僧？我们要先了解，我们要先了解佛法僧的功德，然后之后那一种不会受因缘条件而改变的信心才能够升起。我们要用这样子的心态来做皈依，就是先了解佛法僧三宝的功德。如果说我们不先了解佛法僧三宝的功德，而只是因为我们前辈子前世的善因缘而做了，就是有这么好的福报就皈依了，那但是却不知道三宝的功德，那么这样子的信心是不会稳定的。那如果说明天有人给你一点不同的意见，你就马上就退转了。所以呢，重要在这条修道上最重要的是我们要了解佛法跟三宝的功德。那就像佛陀他自己也讲过了，你们不要盲信我所说的法，你们要自己去检验它是否是真实的，是否是真正有利益的。那就如同炼金师，就是提炼黄金的人，就是佛陀举的例子，炼金就是他们炼金的时候会磨它、烧它，然后去挫它等等。那你们也应该如此来检验我说的吧。如果真的有是真实的、真实不虚的，而且是有利益的，然后你才投入来修行。所以我们要先知道这一点，我们才来做皈依，这样子的话就会很好。那这也就是佛教的哲学所要我们理解的。